Obviously, I'm lost, I said as I entered a small cafeteria set up somewhere in Veterans Hospital in Little Rock. I had driven down to visit my brother-in-law, Carl, who had come in with a heart problem, and as I was leaving the hospital, I realized I was completely turned around. Only two tables were occupied, one over in the corner by an older man who was having a sandwich, and the other by an elderly couple who sat together in the center of the room. The gentleman in the corner said he understood how easy it was to get lost in the place and offered to escort me out when he finished his sandwich. I thanked him, and the man at the center table spoke up and said, "Don't feel bad. I've been coming here since 1945, and I still get lost." "Oh, you are a World War II veteran then," I asked. "Yes," he answered. "I fought in Europe, both me and my brother. We were all over that place, but never ran into each other the whole time we were there. After we came home, we realized that one time we had been in the same place at the same time, but we never knew it. We fought through that war after they sent us over there, and we both came home in one piece. I got wounded a couple of times, but never very badly. I don't know how we managed to come home whole when there were boys dying all around us." I looked him full in the face, completely caught up in the story he was telling. "I know why you and your brother came back," I said, astounding him and myself as well. "You do?" he asked. "Yes," I said, not pausing to think about the absurdity of what I was about to say to a complete stranger. "You and your brother came home because your mother was praying for you." His face lit up with a smile and his eyes shone with pure joy. "You know," he said, "she was praying for us. My mother had something. People made fun of her and called her a holy roller, but it never hindered her." I smiled as I said to him, "Yes, I understand, because my mother was a holy roller too." "We don't have no doubt about where they are now, do we?" he asked me, looking as though he might have just caught a glimpse of our mothers shouting together in Gloryland. "No, we don't," I said, smiling, knowing that my face reflected back to him the same emotion that shone upon his own. The gentleman who had offered to show me out had finished his lunch by this time and came over to walk me out. I thanked the veteran for telling me his story, and he said it was his pleasure. I did not ask his name, and I did not tell him mine, but in that moment I knew him, and he knew me. Names were not important. Something wonderful happened for us in that room, and we both knew it. His wife, who sat quietly by his side during the conversation, smiled sweetly at me as I turned to leave. I returned her smile and gave her a little wave. I could not get the man and his story off my mind as I drove home that day. I have heard and read many stories and watched many movies about World War II, but this little story was as profound to me as any I had ever heard. In that awful time, while a war was tearing the world apart, and bombs and bullets were daily taking an awful toll, a mother was praying for God to bring her boys home to her, and somewhere in a lonely little cabin in the Ozark Mountains of Arkansas, that little mother, down on her knees, moved heaven and earth, and her boys came home.